beta software is going to have beta problems. And the other week I talked about some edge case issues in a project known as uutils. This is the Rust rewrite of the GNU core utils project. Those issues being 8573, check some implementation up to 17 times slower than GNU for some large files, and sort does not finish for large one-line file. This one is an actual performance issue. 17 times slower does sound really bad, but this amounted to a couple of extra seconds. It was a problem, and it has been addressed, and it was addressed when everyone was first talking about it. This one is trying to sort a 4 GB file of the letter A on a singular line. Not really a real world use case, but is still a problem. And whilst this is still open, there is also a fix currently present as well. Now, being edge case issues, most people are not going to come across these in normal everyday usage. And things in the project are in a relatively good state if you look at the testing suite. This is testing it against the GNU test suite. And yes, there are still tests that do fail. And yes, there was a weird uptick right here. Not entirely sure what happened here, but things are generally progressing upwards. And things now are in a mostly passing state, mostly to the point where you can use this and it's probably not going to break on things that you're using most of the time. But do note that no test suite is 100% comprehensive. There's going to be weird, undocumented behavior where it needs to be replicated in uutils, but it's not being covered by the test suite, either because it's something no one even knows it's supposed to be doing, or it's a bug that has existed in the project long enough that it's basically a feature now, and people rely on that bug. If you want to keep an eye on the overall progress towards passing these tests, I'll leave the project page linked in the description down below. And here we have the documentation for the project, which includes any extensions over the GNU tools that these might add as well. The basic attempt for the project, the basic goal for the project, is one-to-one compatibility with GNU. From there, additional things may be added. And now with Ubuntu 25.10 on the horizon, which is the main reason people are talking about uutils, this is a major distro that is going to be shipping with uutils. There are issues being uncovered, which very likely would not be spotted with the normal test suite that GNU is providing, as is reported on by the Phoronix website. Ubuntu 25.10's move to Rust core utils is causing major breakage for some executables. And this is one of those rare cases that Michael actually ran into the problem himself. I noticed a number of benchmarks failing to run on Ubuntu 25.10 this week and reported check some issues on the files. I quickly realized it's due to the recent Rust core utils transition for 25.10 causing some major breakage for those relying on make self archives. This week when working on some new Ubuntu 25.10 benchmarks, I was surprised to find some MD5 checksum errors being hit. That looked a little like this, verifying archive integrity, error in MD5 checksums, this string here is different from this string here. Basically, a checksum is a way to take two separate files and then run some fancy math on them and say, are these files the same file? And normally, if those are the same file, you know, those are going to show up as the same string. And that's what's supposed to happen here because he knows that these are the same file. This was happening with the Unigine benchmarks. Their built-in MD5 detection is now failing, or with the Gravity Mark benchmark also having the same problem. This was initially quite surprising, since all of my benchmark files are cached locally on a LAN server and are all checksummed as well. So the same exact files that I always use for these benchmarks were being run, and they have always run fine on other Linux distributions without ever hitting an MD5 error. And the common denominator to these benchmarks and others having similar MD5 errors now were that they are make self archives for these generic Linux executables. And in turn, these make self archives are running at the MD5 sum command. This command is provided either by the GNU core utils or by uutils. Now, just in case you don't know, a make self archive is basically it's a self-extractable tar file. If you want to learn more about them and how to work with them, I'll leave the website linked in the description down below, but that's the main thing that you need to know. You click on the file, and the file just does all the magical running stuff itself. And sure enough, once replacing the Rust Core utils with the GNU Core utils on Ubuntu 25.10, the same exact files now ran successfully without MD5 errors. Looks like there's some subtle differences between MD5 sum from GNU Core utils, and Rust Core utils is breaking files from at least makeself. This is not actually the problem, but this is what a lot of people thought the problem initially was. So the problem was also reported over on Launchpad, makeself archive failing MD5 at validation. This time it wasn't with a benchmark though, it was with VirtualBox guest editions. Again, having the exact same criteria, the MD5 checksum is different even though they are the same files and it shouldn't be different. And when done on a 2504 system, there is no problem. The checksums are the same, even though, again, they are the exact same files. I was sure this was due to the switchover of the waste of time Core Utils Rust rewrite. Please ignore the editorial comment. But copying over Core Utils MD5 sum from 2504 does not eliminate the error. So taking the MD5 sum from Core Utils and replacing the uutils version with it doesn't fix the problem. What that says is this is not a problem in MD5 sum. This bug was also taken to the VirtualBox project, and weirdly, initially the dev here wasn't able to replicate it. They were told the version of Ubuntu it was on 25.10, and the problem didn't appear to be there. But other users were able to find the problem with no issue at all, so it seemed like what the issue here was there was a distinction between new installs and upgraded installs and when you acquired the files. Anyway, eventually, the dev was able to replicate the problem after quite a bit of back and forth. We got to this one here. And like I was saying before, MD5 sum was not the problem. That's just where the problem showed itself. Just a bit more observations from my side. While debugging .run script, I noticed that the binary data, a tail of .run, which is a subject to be passed to MD5 sum, is sometimes truncated. Actually, when --- no progress option is passed into .run, the chances of success are higher. So the data being sent into MD5 sum is sometimes different. And if the data is different, of course the sums are gonna be different. They are different streams of data. But this means it's not a problem in MD5 sum, or at least it doesn't appear to be a problem there. It's something before that point. Long story short, .run script generated by makeself is a script which is appended by a binary data which in turn represents .tar archive containing guest editions. Script will pass entire of itself to DD via input redirection, and DD will pass it further into MD5 sum. Skipping to the point when binary.tar data begins, out of the box, script will pass BS, which is block size option, to DD for it to be aware of how much to skip from the beginning of input data and on later while loop iterations. This seems to be handled by DD either improperly or at least in a different way than it was in the past with the GNU Core utils. However, once BS is replaced with IBS, all seems to go back to normal. At this point, I would not state whether it is an Ubuntu 25.10 bug or not, but would certainly draw their attention to this. So it doesn't appear to be a problem in MD5 sum, but instead in DD, otherwise known as Disk Destroyer, or you can fill in the word. Okay, so here we have a pull request over in makeself. Only skip offset. The DD option skip seeks the input stream. An additional count reads the specified bytes from the input and outputs it. This caused the last bytes read to be incorrect. And this is the change over in DD. Ensure full block writes to handle partial writes to slow pipes. The partial write bug in uutils DD occurs when writing large blocks to a pipe with a slow reader, resulting in truncated output. The key area of interest is how DD handles writing data to the output destination. The current implementation retries writing if the write operation is interrupted, which is correct. However, it does not handle the case where a partial write occurs without being interrupted. When writing to a pipe with a slow reader, the kernel may return a partial write less than the requested amount, without an error. Since iflags.fullblock is typically not set for output operations, it's meant for input, the loop exits after the first partial write, leading to a truncated output. Now, whilst there is a fix here and there is some testing for it, it's not entirely perfect. While this eliminates this particular way of triggering this problem, if I'm reading the main loop break condition code correctly, it would still exit in a situation where there was still data left in the write buffer, but no more data left to read from the input. Now, this is one of those issues which you are probably never going to find unless you had actual real-world users, not just a couple of them, but people trying things out. Because DD works mostly fine, MD5-SUM doesn't even appear to have a problem here whatsoever. It's the combination of the two. The combination of DD and MD5-SUM, which was never going to appear in the GNU testing, using it with this make-self archive. If you ever want a project like this to be good, you kind of have to accept the fact that you have to have a bad release. And that's what 25.10 is going to be. 25.10 is gonna be rough. It's gonna be buggy. And that's the only way that you can actually fix uutils. Now, a lot of people are gonna say, I don't think there's any reason to do this uutils thing. This is all dumb, this is a waste of effort. And that's fine to have that opinion. But that's not the direction that the Canonical is going. They want to adopt it, and if they're gonna want to do that, then they have to just say, this is gonna be bad right off this release, because it's most likely not gonna be there in the next version. But a couple of years down the line, when more problems are ironed out, then you're very likely going to see it make its way into an LTS version. And you know what? Beta software has beta versions. And if you're the kind of person that runs the latest Ubuntu release, I wish you the best of luck, because, well, you're going to need it. But if you run across bugs, please do go and report them, because that's the only way that projects like this actually go and improve. Anyway, if you liked the video, go like the video. Really like the video, you want to subscribe, go do that. And if you really, gonna get there eventually. If you really, really like the video, be sure to check out the Patreon, subscribe, Stanley, Bearapay, link down below. These amazing people over here, I forgot how my outro works. I'm just gonna end the video. What is this?